Isang mapagpalang araw po sa inyong lahat and welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. Ang ebanghelyo po natin ngayon ay napaka-interesting, no? Sapagkat makikita natin yung contrast at nung movement, napaka-interesting po. Ang main characters ng ating ebanghelyo ngayon, of course, we have Jesus Christ and we have a rich young man. Rich young man. Mayaman, bata na lalaki o binatang lalaki. At sa panahon ng ating Panginoon, kapag sinabi nating lalaki, first class citizen yan. At pag sinabi nating binata, so blessed ka niyan. Kasi yan yung panahon, yan yung edad kung saan you are so productive. At pag sinabi pang mayaman, sobrang blessed ka na ng Diyos. Because you are a rich young man. But this rich young man ran up to Jesus. When Jesus was about to leave, this rich young man ran up to Jesus. Mayaman, matipuno, makisig siguro, at lalaki, binata. Pero tumakbo dahil gusto niyang kausapin, habulin ang ating Panginoon. Siguro masasabi natin sa o madedescribe natin yung rich young man sa kanta na sikat noon, no? Nasa kanya na ang lahat. Nasa iyo na ang lahat. Ngunit siya'y tumakbo tungo kay Kristo. Because he was so eager to meet Jesus Christ, to ask Jesus Christ a question. And this question is, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" That rich young man, in fact, in the Gospel of St. Luke, no? Jesus described, or St. Luke described that rich young man as not only a rich young man, but a very rich man. A very rich young man. But he was asking Jesus Christ, "What must I do to inherit eternal life?" He has everything. But he was asking, ano ba yung gagawin ko dapat? Nasa akin naman yung kayamanan, nasa akin na yung kabataan, nasa akin na yung lakas. But Lord, I want to inherit. Other translations would say, I want to gain eternal life. Nakamit ko na lahat yung nasa yung pwedeng makamit sa lupa. Lord, I want to inherit eternal life. And Jesus said, "You know the commandments." And the rich young man said, "Lord, I have done all of them since I was still young. I have been so faithful, observant of these commandments." And Jesus looked at him, and Saint Mark also described, Jesus looked at him, loved him, and said, "You are lacking in one thing." The question of the rich young man, even though he has everything, was actually a question of pagkukulang. And if we would translate this question in our own understanding, actually the rich young man was asking, "Lord, am I good enough? Have I done enough?" Because he is asking for something that he wants, that he lacks. "Lord," or "Teacher, am I good enough?" He has everything. But he is asking himself, he is asking the Lord, "Am I good enough? I have done many things, I have been observant of the commandments, but am I good enough?" But you know what? This question was also asked by Jesus to the rich young man. Jesus saw that this rich young man has done everything. And so he said, "Go and sell everything and follow me." But that rich young man could not let go of his wealth, of his riches. because he was attached to them. He was possessed by them. Most of the time, our possessions are the ones possessing us. And so Jesus was actually asking the rich young man, let go of everything. Here am I. Follow me. Rich young man, am I not good enough for you? You know, my dear brothers and sisters, when I hear vocation stories from our dear brothers, Dominican brothers, priests, I'm always inspired by people who have achieved so many things in life. But this knowing question deep in their hearts, that question, am I good enough? And then later on, realizing that Jesus Christ is asking them, am I not good enough for you? And responding to that question by letting go of their careers, their promising lives, and responding to Jesus Christ, Lord, here I am. You are good enough for me. While the rich young man recognized Jesus as the good teacher, sadly, he did not see Jesus as good enough to fulfill the desire of his heart, good enough to let go of his wealth and riches and follow him. That is why, at first, the rich young man was so excited, eager, running towards Jesus. Towards the end of the gospel, the rich young man, his face fell, he was downcast. He's not anymore running. He was walking slowly away from Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, most of the time, if not always, we think of perfection in the Christian life as achieving, attaining, gaining, getting. But the paradox of Christian life is not achieving, it's giving up. That's why in the verse before the gospel, it says, Jesus Christ became poor, although he was rich, so that by his poverty, we might become rich. True riches are not the wealth of this world. True riches are those that which cannot moth, or those that which moth cannot destroy, or rust could not decay. True riches are in heaven. True riches are found only in Christ. And the true rich one is the one who enriches people. Rich young man, very promising life, and here is Jesus Christ on the other hand, also a young man, but poor, but in his poverty, he enriches others. He enriches us.